Okay, I think this is working. We had about 20 people tuned in to the other video, waiting for it to start, but for some reason it did not start. And I don't know why that is. So I'm really sorry. I'm gonna give people a few minutes to find out about this one. When people are here, can you just say something in the chat? I'll make a note of that here as well. This is my first time doing this, so you'll have to excuse the technical difficulties. Okay. Here we go. I see that we're getting some people over here. We got four. Okay. Yeah, sorry about the confusion. Some issues with YouTube and with the stream. I think partly because so many people are on the internet right now, so streaming is a bit more difficult. I think that in the future, I'm gonna have to go to a place with a professional. Hey, Ugo, it's good to see you. In the future, I'm gonna have to do this from a place that has better internet. I believe that was the problem that we had here. YouTube simply told me streaming not available. So I hope that everybody who wanted to watch it sees that I'm doing this now. Because we were at 21 and now we're only at 7. But you know, I'll give it a couple minutes and I'll just play. Can you guys give me feedback on the volume? How does that sound? Volume okay? Volume is good? All right, cool. Well, I'm happy to see a few of you actually figured out how to make it here. It looks like we lost most of the people, which is a bummer. If any of you know any people who meant to be watching this, can you just let them know to go back to my channel and they can find this here? Robert, when you say maybe down a touch, do you mean to turn it down a little bit? Thank you for the feedback, Robert. That's super helpful. I'm gonna move the mic a little further away. Okay, there we go. Yeah, any feedback is great, guys. I've never done this before, so the first couple times aren't gonna be the most awesome. I'm just gonna do what I can, but every time's gonna get a little bit better. I will say this, next time I plan on using a high quality camera. Today I'm just using my webcam on my iMac. I got a really nice microphone for this, so I hope that sounds good. That's obviously the most important thing, but I want it to look good as well next time. It's just really difficult to attach a nice camera to your computer for live streaming. Who knew? So for today, I'm gonna play several pieces. We're not gonna have a super long show, but I wanted to do just some soothing music, nothing intense, nothing frenetic, keeping it nice and calm, you know, adding a bit of stress relief for people here, hopefully. So if people have any requests, you can drop those in the comments. And I'll just start playing something for you. All right.
Thank you.
Boy, it's a little weird playing in my room by myself here, knowing that there's people out there watching. It's really good to see all of you people showed up. And thank you for leaving comments so that I know who's here. It's really good to see, hey, Trip and Pearl and Dave. Dave Drury is in the room, my first guitar teacher, which is pretty awesome. I hope to help him get set up to do similar things because he's an amazing jazz guitarist. There's a friend from Spain, a few of them. Hugo is here. Old friend from Valladolid, I hope you're doing well. So, hey Joe, hey Aaron. So anyways, it's really good to see everybody here. I'm sorry about the video quality. I said this earlier. I need to figure out how to get an external camera set up into a live stream, and that's not the easiest thing in the world. But I do have a good microphone that I bought just for this. So I'm going to be doing this every week or two. We'll see what feels right. But I would like to do these on a somewhat regular basis to give all of you out there a little, you know, feeling of normalcy, something hopefully beautiful and relaxing to experience during these bizarre times. And also, I will just say this. I'm going to be doing this out of a different location that has a better internet connection in the future because I'm at my house. A lot of people live here, so it doesn't sound the best. Hey, Aaron, maybe you can help me with the cat filters. I don't know how to do that, so that would be pretty awesome. So I'm going to keep it on the softer and more relaxing side of things today. So I'm just going to play another relaxing piece. It's called Lágrima. It means tear in Spanish. Assume everybody's at home clapping. like I said, this is weird playing here. Thanks, Aaron. It's a meaningful compliment in moments like this. Pretty cool. We got 30 people here. 31. That's awesome, guys. Thank you for showing up. Hey, Mom. It's good to see you, too. I wish we could have with the amount of people like this, do like a Zoom conference so I could see everyone. But whatever. We're doing what we can. All right. I'm going to play. And by the way, if anybody has any requests that I may or may not be able to honor, please ask them. I would love for this to be as natural of an experience as possible. And I like to do requests sometimes. So, you know, but I'm going to play, an Eric Satie piece. That's one of my favorites. It's called No Cien Number One. And, yeah, it's super relaxing. It's from a really good movie called Chocolat. So I'm sure a lot of people will recognize it. Idea while I was playing that. I would appreciate if you guys out there, wherever you are in the world, in the comments and, you know, give me a week or two to brush up on some of those. But I promise that I will perform them, the ones that are, you know, learnable in a certain time period. Because I haven't been able to perform as much as usual, obviously. So I'm not super in practice in terms of just knowing 3 or 4 hours of music off the top of my head. So yeah, think about some pieces you might like to hear. Hey, Patty and Michael, it's really good to see you guys. Yeah. Hope you're doing all right. let's play a let's play a piece in drop D here. Play one that's a little bit more fun, a little bit more charming. Well, that last piece was pretty charming. Similarly charming, but really chill at the same time. So that was La Paloma, yet another piece from Spain. Looks like I'm going to do a few of those today, huh? Man, I really wish I could see all of you, but it's great. We're almost up to 40 people now. Yeah, that's better than actual shows, so awesome. I also want to take a moment to thank everybody who has reached out to me, this is just on a very personal note, to help be supportive during this time. I would not be able to still be making music if people had not been so generous. All of the new patrons that I have that have signed up on my Patreon page, the people who have made PayPal donations, I really, really hope to be able to keep dedicating time to doing this kind of thing, to making videos on my YouTube channel, to streaming concerts, maybe to doing neighborhood concerts where people can listen from their porches. That's a plan that I have for once the weather clears up a little bit in Portland. But I feel like that's the most important thing I can contribute right now. We all need beauty and we all need art in our lives. And I really hope to be able to keep doing that. So the people who have helped make that possible, I don't know how to thank you enough. I really don't. I suppose this is one of the ways. Trying to give back a little bit. Any requests? I can see you in the chat here, so I'm watching your comments. Well, while we wait for requests, I will play one of my favorite pieces and one of the first pieces I ever learned. I learned it badly a long time ago, and hopefully I play it a little bit better now. It's another piece from Spain. It's called Capricho Árabe. Cheers. Cool. All right. I also want to thank everyone for 200 subs. I got over 200 subscribers finally. So trying to get this thing up and running on YouTube. Okay, so let's see here. Aaron Torres asks about the third Eric Satie Gymnopédie movement. Yeah, it's a really nice piece, for sure. I hope that you asked it because you have noticed that I'm already in that tuning. That would be very astute of you. We'll give it a go. We'll give it a go. I haven't played it for months, but I've played it many, many, many times in my life. So it might be fine. And if it's not fine, then I will just play something else. Hey, louder. Yeah, I'll play that. Okay, let's do this. Cool. I remembered it. Thanks for the request, Aaron. Haven't played that since my last actual gig in the outdoor world. Hey, George Koshinen. Wow, so many people showing up. It's great. Okay, so let's see. I don't know any music from Hamilton. I'm sorry, Grace. I wish I did. I'm going to play one for... she's in Italy right now, I would think. She's Italian, so I hope you're doing okay. All right, get a little more energy going here. Hold on, gotta tune a little bit. Thank you. All right, there we go. Well, I think that's probably pretty good for today. We're at 40 minutes already. Still see 36 of you are here. I haven't, so to elaborate on that prior idea, I think it would be great if in the comment section of this video, because it will be posted to my YouTube channel, leave some pieces that you would like me to play. Fine, I'll play a couple more, all right? But I just want to say this. Leave some pieces that you would like me to learn in the comment section. And I will think about those, and I will learn the ones that I can, if not for the next concert, then the one after that or the one after that. Who knows how long, honestly, this is going to be going on for. We need to learn to be comfortable connecting in this way, unfortunately, but we have to make the most out of it. So I do plan on continuing to do these things. I plan on getting better at doing these things. I think the audio is probably decent from what I've heard. But we're gonna get some better video going, especially since I work in video now. It's an embarrassment to me to have to use this crappy webcam. Yeah, I can do some pop music, Aaron. Do some Beatles or something. But that'll have to be next time. So, tune in next time for my cover of Blackbird. All right. Yeah, you're welcome, Laura. Thank you for the request. You guys are great. Let's see here. Okay. For those of you who are unfamiliar with it, Granada is the name of a city in the south of Spain. It's one of the most beautiful cities in the world. I have not seen all the cities in the world, but I still feel pretty confident saying that. It's in the top three that I've ever been to, for sure. Yeah, a lot of you have been there with me, even. So, anyways, I feel like this piece does just a phenomenal and unbelievably good job of reflecting the atmosphere of being in that city, of walking through the Alhambra, one of the most famous structures in the world. So when you hear me play this, just think about orange blossoms in the springtime and fountains in the town square and horses going down the street and all sorts of beautiful Andalusian things like that. Okay. All right, here we go. I'll answer those last two questions here in a second. Thank you. right. Well, I think that will be it for today. Getting closer and closer to an hour here. I know that some of us do have things to do. I guess some of us probably really don't. Anyways, so I really want to do this again soon. Thank you everyone for tuning in. It's been awesome to have this many people here still after 50 minutes. So I hope to have some of the technical details ironed out so that everybody who wants to sign up will just automatically be able to tune in and I won't have to go start another stream. I don't understand what happened, but I'll figure that out between this time and next time. I don't know. How long should it be? Should it be a week or a couple weeks? Like, how often should I do this? What do you guys think? I really have no idea. Once again, leave a comment on the actual video once it posts on YouTube about how often I should do this. I really want to keep doing this for people. I will have links to my music for people to download and to my Patreon account for people who want to become patrons. I meant to do that this time, but things were messed up. So we're doing what we can. Anyways, thank you everybody. And, I might do it weekly. People are seeming to think that's a good frequency. So I would love to do this once a week and it gives me something to practice for. It keeps me motivated. I realized during all of this time that I've been taking the presence of music in my life a little bit for granted. And then once it was taken away from me in terms of having any venues to perform in, I really realized that. And I need to do this to connect with people. It's just part of who I am at this point. So for the people wondering what to do with requests, when I post this video after this is done, you just leave them in the comments there. I'm going to post all of these to my YouTube channel. I'll create a special playlist for them for live performances. And you can leave requests there. You can also leave them in the chat here, but all right, I can play one more. All right, fine. I'll do one more. I don't know which one to do. Really didn't have a whole lot planned for today. So let's see, what do I feel like playing? I am drinking out of your mug. It's a really appropriate mug for these days. This is a mug that our old roommate Katie left. It has the Serenity Prayer on it, which is wonderful because it reminds us to focus on the things that we actually can control. So never has that been more important than now, right? All right, so for the people saying Bach, I will do Bach next time. I want to work on that one a little bit. I just feel like it would be a pity to get to the climax of the song and forget where I'm going. It's just such beautiful music. I'll play. Gosh, what do I want to play here? Just give me 5 seconds to think about this. Yeah, that's right, Mom. My mom is Carrie Ferber on here. That's right. It's good to give people some heads up. They should bring their Kleenex if they're gonna. It would be unfair of me to just spring it on people because they would start crying and then not have any Kleenex on hand. Okay. Okay. Yeah, good mom tip. That's right. That is a good mom tip. Okay, I'll play a tremolo piece for you guys. Bye, Grace. It was good to see you. I hope to see you next time and to stay in touch. Okay, I'm going to play a tremolo piece because I've been working on my tremolo technique a little bit. For those of you who are unfamiliar with that term, for the non-classical guitarists in the room, it is a technique where you play four notes really quickly. So one, two, three, four. And they're kind of meant to blend together to create the effect of one sustained note. All right? It's one of the more fun techniques that we have available on our instrument. I think also one of the more difficult ones, so you gotta work at it a lot, but I've had time to do that in the last week, so. And also, a bizarre and unexpected consequence of all of this is that since I have been playing much, much less, performing much less, my nails have grown out a little bit, which makes tremolo a lot easier. So, who knew? Now I know. Here we go. This is a piece by one of my very favorite composers. His name is Agustin Barrios. He was born one century to the day before me. I like to tell people that because it's bizarre. We're both 5'5", 85. He's just 1885. All right. And this is the last piece he ever wrote. Thank you. Broken hour. So there we go. Yeah, it's really great to see everybody here. I know a lot of you know each other, which is cool. It's like we all get to hang out for a little bit. Got some friends from Spain who know each other, some friends from Astoria, a lot of Portland people, other places in the world, some friends from college. It's great. So I kind of forgot where I was at one point in that piece, but it's all good, you know? So I look forward to practicing a little bit, getting some of the technical aspects of this figured out a little bit better, and doing it again soon. Let's say in about a week, we'll do it again. I'll post information about the next online performance on all of my social media a couple times. I'll send out a newsletter to everybody in my email list. People who are paying a little attention will know about it. Thank you guys. It was really awesome to hang out for a little bit. I didn't intend on playing for an hour, but here we are. I hope people enjoyed it. Thank you for showing up. We had a better turnout than I expected, honestly. Thank you everybody. And thank you for participating in the chat. It makes me feel like I'm not quite so alone in my room here. Until next time, take care, everybody. Be safe. See you soon.